sales and distribution. So we are going to see the sales and distribution activities in our course. Okay. So our sales and sales activities, in the sense like we talk about creating both sales orders as well as the pre-sales documents. Some of the pre-sales documents in ours are inquiry, quotation, and along that we have the sales order. Then for the sales order we create a delivery. Based on the delivery we create the picking, then we do the goods issue, and then we bill the customer. Okay. So let us go in still more detail. So we have a clerk or somebody receptionist sitting in the office, and when the customer calls and asks like, okay, I'll be needing so and so, so and so article and so and so date, so and so quantity, then the then your clerk or secretary or your personal assistant, somebody, they take down the customer's requirement in the form of inquiry. Okay. Once they have created an inquiry, and they will tell to you like, okay, somebody has called. Okay, else you might even you can have your you can record the requirements in form of inquiry. Okay, once the recording of inquiry is done in form of inquiry, then you go for creating a quotation. What is a quotation, anybody? Okay. So what are all the things that will be in the quotation? Okay. Okay, other than the tool tag, delivery. Okay, we have the delivery period. Okay, then we have the price and we have the validity for the quotation. Okay, so we have all these things in the quotation. Okay, then once we send to the customer, then the customer will come back. The customer will say like, okay, this is fine, or okay, this is so then the customer can come back with the purchase order for the either for complete quantity or partial quantity of the quotation. Okay. So then based on the purchase order you create the sales orders. Even though our process starts at inquiry, sometimes like it happens that we don't have considered that inquiry and quotation as a mandatory. So normally our all the sales process begins with the sales order. Okay. So then we create the sales order. Okay. Then when you create the sales order, what are the details I will enter? I will enter the customer number. I will enter the PO reference number. Then the material, quantity. That's it. The system automatically carries out several activities in the background. For example, it will automatically calculate the prices. Okay, I am not going to manually enter the prices. Instead, the system will automatically pick up the prices from the condition record. Okay. It will carry out an availability check and say, for example, if the customer has requested a delivery date on 25th, the system will check whether the full quantity can be given on 25th. If possible, it will give confirm it for 25th. If not possible, then the system will confirm the complete delivery or partial deliveries at the later date when the material is available. Okay. So the system carries out the availability check in the background. If you have enabled the credit management for the customer, it will carry out the credit management in the background. Okay. Then you save that order. Okay. Once you save that order, then it is for somebody else to process. So now let us shift the scene to the warehouse. Because from our warehouse here, that is something else. We will see that later. Okay. As of now, we are talking from the scenario where we have sufficient stocks. So then this scenario shifts from our sales office to warehouse, because from the warehouse only the goods are being delivered. So now there will be somebody called as a warehouse clerk. He will be creating the deliveries. For example, every morning once he comes to office, he will be having a delivery run, which says like, okay, these are all the sales orders that has to be converted to delivery today. So he will create the deliveries. Once he creates the deliveries, those deliveries has to be taken into, has to be processed. So we will be having so many articles or materials in the delivery. Okay. So those things has to be picked from the warehouse and it has to be collected in the shipping cart and then taken to the delivery clerk. Okay. But he is a delivery clerk. He is not a menial labor to do these things. So he has to instruct the menial labor, okay, like you have to go and pick those articles and put it in the shipping cart and bring it to me. So that guy will ask, okay, what I have to do. Okay. So for that purpose, you create something called as transfer order. Transfer order or LTO, local transfer order. Transfer order is the document for moving the goods within the warehouse from one location to another location. Then the delivery clerk creates a transfer order. It takes a printout to the printout of it and give it to the picking person. The picking person goes through the warehouse, picks up everything from the shelf, puts it in the shopping cart and comes back. Okay. Then the warehouse clerk does the post goods issue. Goods issue means I am issuing the goods to my customer. The moment I issue the goods to my customer, it's like it carries out several activities in the background automatically. For example, my inventory is reduced because I had given to the customer. The ownership transfers from myself to the customer, okay, which means the system updates, okay, these are the things that has to, this much of amount has to be taken from the customer. Okay. So, then it updates your planning. So much of goods has gone out. So based on the reorder level or something, so the system will go for planning. Any planning will be taken care of the purchasing, so let us leave that. So once you do the goods issue, which means like you had transferred the ownership to the customer, then you bill for the delivery. Okay. You bill for the delivery by creating a invoice. And based on your payment, pardon? No, I am not charging anything, only this. Okay. Then once you send the invoice to the customer, based on the payment terms agreed, for example, 15 days or 30 days, 60 days, whatever it could be. So based on the payment terms, the customer sends you the money, of which you record in the incoming payment. Okay. So we are going to see the cycle in SAP first. I want you people to get familiarized. Okay, because only when you know what you are doing, you will be getting an idea of what are the things you have to customize. Okay. So let us go to SAP. I mean, like if you want, you can take down the path now. There will be some lag to upload the recording. So till then you have to work. So you have to take it down the notes. Okay. Logistics, sales and distribution. Sales. What are these? No. I told you to take down the notes. Okay. Go to order. Create. Either you can go through this path or you can use the transaction code VA01. Okay. Enter the order type OR. Of you three, I suggest you people use one customer for each. For example, let Sirisha use the customer T-62A01. And let Preeti use A02 and Abid use A03. Okay. creating sales order. No, you can create later, but I want you to use this customer. Each of you use separate customers, don't overlap. Okay. So let's finish and create the materials and customers with the suffix 01, Preeti use 02 and you use 03. Okay. T-ATA01, okay. My quantity is 2 and I use T-ATB01, 2 pieces. These are the only things I entered. This customer is existing in 2 sales areas, that is why it asked. T-ATB. Now, Sirisha, mute your microphone. So what are the things I entered? I just entered the customer number in the sold to party field, 1, and this is the PO number field, 2nd I populated, then I populated the materials. So only 3 and the quantity. The system automatically took so many details like what is the required delivery date and from which date it should be priced, and what is the payment term for the customer, and what is the price quoted, whether it is a cost freight included or ex works, whatever it should be, inco terms. Then when I pressed the material, the system showed, okay, what is the price, from which plant it is going to be delivered. And I can still go in further details like when it can be delivered, I mean what are the schedule lines. So I select that and I use this button, or I can double click that line itself. Okay. I go to display item level. You can see a many number of tabs. The system takes all this master data and populates these tabs. Okay. So for example, if I go to shipping, I can say from which plant it is being the goods are being delivered and which shipping point is being used. Okay, from in which route the material is traveling. In which route the material is traveling. Okay. Then I go to schedule line. Schedule line means it is giving me a schedule. Okay. So it says okay, on 30th the system can confirm me 2 pieces. Okay, in another situation, if on 30th, this 30th came because this is our record delivery date populated in the sales order. If the system doesn't have the sufficient quantity on 30th, let me say like if it is having this record goods on some other date, the system will have the confirmed quantity as 0 in the first line, and then if you create the second line, in that line only the confirmed quantity will be there. As of now, we have sufficient stock, so we are getting only 1 line. Okay. Then you have the partners. Partners means like, we'll see the partner functionalities later. As of now, if the system says like, okay, this is the guy to whom the goods has been delivered to, that is the ship to party, and the sales employee is the one who is handling this delivery, or the sales order, and he is the payer is somebody with whom you are going to receive the payments from. Okay. Then let's come back. Okay. So the data are stored in 2 levels. We had seen the item level. Okay. whatever you had seen in the item are data specific to certain items only. Okay. For example, we have the plant and setting point defined separately at the item level. Okay. Item number 10 goes from this plant and item number 20 also using this plant. Okay, fine. What happens in real time is sometimes the materials will be handled in separate plants based on your storage condition. For example, let me say like I am coupling energy food articles or edible articles along with my some other articles. And let me say those edible articles or food articles need the special storage, let me say cold storage or deep frozen storages. Okay. And let me again say like I have two plants, plant A and plant B. Plant A is having the normal storage, whereas plant B doesn't have the normal storage. I mean, plant A doesn't have the normal storage. It has the frozen cold storage, whereas plant B has the normal storage, which means in the sales order, the articles which require the cold storage or frozen storage, that will be stored in the plant 1 and the rest of the articles can be stored in plant 2. When you create a sales order with this, both the articles in the same sales order, line 1, that is the first line of the sales order or the first article of your sales order, will be taken from plant 1 and the second article will be taken from plant 2. Okay. So based on certain parameters, the system will determine the shipping conditions. By assignment, if both the plants have the same shipping point, then it will be creating only one delivery. And if the shipping points are splitted, then it will create multiple deliveries for each shipping point. As of now, we have only one, I mean, we have the common plant and common shipping point, so it should not be a problem for us. We had seen the item level data, yeah? Yeah, it's automatically proposed. And we will see the proposal, I mean, how the automatic proposal comes at the later time. Okay. So then you go to the display of header details. The data are stored at three levels in the sales order. One is the header level, one is the item level, and third one is the schedule line level. Okay. So let me, the item has its own data based on the each material's conditions. So that is what I said, like the items can have different plants, different storage locations in the same sales order itself. Okay. I go to the header. Header data is common for all the articles or whole of the sales documents. So that is why you can find the details like the customer data, the customer's payment terms or billing terms. Okay, that will be coming from the header conditions. It doesn't have anything related to items. So there is no, here can you see there only unloading point is there for the customer. There is no plant somewhere the goods have to be delivered or something. Okay. Here you have the from which sales office this guy will be serviced from. Okay. Then if you go to billing documents, okay, what is his INCO terms, what is his payment terms. Okay. So these kind of things will be there. And I select the item and I click this ninth button, schedule lines for item. We saw that in this. I go to schedule lines. Here, the based on the schedule lines, okay, it shows whether it has to be, that's what Abid asked sometime back, whether it should go for make to order or it has to be purchased from. Right now, we are seeing the situation of sale from stock. What happens sometimes, your company will be selling the customized product, which means those articles won't be in stock and they will be prepared or produced only based on your sales order. Let me say an example of your car. Okay, the car has so many variants. There will be somebody will be preferring some color. Okay, somebody will be preferring the leather upholstery. Somebody will be preferring the cheap ones. Whereas somebody will need the music player, somebody don't. Okay, somebody will prefer some kind of AC, somebody doesn't. Okay. So there are so many variations. And you cannot make these cars and put it in stock because that might not meet any of the customer's requirement. Yeah, so those things will be produced only when you create the sales order. So the moment you create a sales order, the system transfers those requirements to production. Then the production will produce that and will intimate the sales people that okay, your things have been produced. Okay, then you can go for delivery. So similarly, there is something called as procurement. For example, certain items won't be there in stock, and based on your sales order only, they will be going for procurement. So these kind of things you can see it here in the schedule line level. For us, it is a normal sales from the stock, so you won't have any details in the procurement level. Okay. If the system calls for purchase requisition, then you can see the purchase requisition numbers and other things here. Okay, here in this field, you will be having the purchase requisition populated. As of now, it is a normal sale from stock, so you don't have anything from here. Okay. So I'm going to save this sales order. Before saving the sales order, I'm just looking, having, okay, my delivery is on 30th and my shipping point is on 12th. Okay. Now I click the sales order. So what are the things, Preeti, what are the things I entered in the sales order before creating? Yeah, customer. That is the customer number. Now that will be automatically taken based on the customer. Now what are the things we populated in the sales order? Okay. Yeah, that's what she said, like how many numbers, okay. That's it. We entered only three things. One is the customer number, second one is the material, and third one is the required quantity. That's it, okay. So, we had saved the standard order, or sales order, which is 100266. Okay. Now, I have to create a delivery for this. I double click the status bar, it automatically took. Okay. It came in the message came in the status bar. So let us go to the creating the delivery, logistics, sales and distribution, shipping and transportation, outbound delivery, create, single document with reference to sales order. Okay. And if, I mean this is the path, the transaction code for this is VL01N. Okay. So what was the shipping point in our sales order? It was 1200. And our record date was 27, then the system changed to 30. So 31-2008. And this is the sales order number. The system copied everything from the sales order directly. So here also you don't have much work. All you gave was only the shipping point and the delivery date, shipping point, delivery date and the sales order number. That's it. Okay. So the system has created, here also you can have so many tabs. If you go to the each tab, you can find when is the picking activity to be done and when is the loading done and what is all the transportation planning date. So everything you can see that. Okay. here also you can have the header level as well as the item level. Okay. In the header level I can see what are all the dates this delivery is going to be processed and from which plant it is being carried out, shipping point, from which shipping point this delivery is going to be processed from. Okay, so these kind of data will be here. Okay. I am saving the delivery. Now, okay, as just now my role is the warehouse clerk and I am creating the delivery. So I had created the delivery. Okay. Now I am going to help my picker or menial labor to carry out the picking activities. So for that purpose I am going to create a picking order. Okay. So the parts is like sales and distribution, shipping and transportation, close that outbound delivery, come to picking, okay. Create transfer order for a single document. The transaction code is LT03. Okay. Okay, this warehouse number is populated in the delivery picking tab itself. So you will see that /OVL03N. I am seeing the delivery. If you go to picking tab, you can see the warehouse number here. So this warehouse number is what you have to populate there. So 012 and we have the delivery. So I press. Okay. So this is my transfer order. What the transfer order says, this is the delivery and this is the material and in this location it is there in this so and so plant and you have to take this much of quantity. It doesn't have anything else. It doesn't have, I mean it just gives the your delivery reference. You can create a single transfer order for more than one delivery. Okay, so that is the reason why this delivery tab is there. Which means like okay, you are picking these materials for this particular delivery. So this is the intention of this tab here. Okay. So you create a PO item. Okay. Save it. The moment you save it, it becomes a transfer order. Now you have to take a printout of this transfer order and give it to your delivery, I mean picking people. Okay. Now let me confirm the transfer order. Okay, like the picking guy says like okay, I had taken so and so good, so I am confirming it. Okay. Single document in single step, okay, is already confirmed. Okay, fine. So now I go back to my delivery. I close the picking. I go to outbound delivery. Okay. So change. I go to the change mode of single shipment VL02N. Okay. Now if you come to the picking tab, it says overall status is fully picked, which means all the goods are picked. Now, and can you see the picked quantity is automatically populated based on your transfer order. Okay. So now you had fully picked and your overall status is your transfer order is confirmed. Okay. I had confirmed the transfer order that I had taken so and so. Now I am going to do the goods issue. The moment I press this button, everything is, I mean like the ownership transfers, the lot of activities take care at the, I mean take place at the background. So I am going to do the post goods issue. Okay, before posting goods issue, let me show you how the system reduces the inventory. So what is my material? It is ATA01 and it is in ATB01. Okay, so I am just going to show you the stock. So what is the stock now? 1959 right now. Okay. So let us okay, 1959 is the stock now. Now I am going to I will tell you later. Okay. No, that is okay. I just wanted to show you the stock. You will learn it later, actually. The thing is, like, Abhid, only thing is, like, you had already exposure to SAP, whereas these others two are not. Okay, the more you give now, at this moment, it will be intimidating for them. So that is why, like, it's not like I don't want to tell you. We will tell you, I mean, you know, gradually. Okay. So, I'm doing the post goods issue. Posting is possible. No. Actually, they had just changed the server number. Okay, so it is having some problem with it. They have to speak to somebody from support only. Okay, let us just wait for them. Yeah, they have changed the thing, and now I am noticing the date is also in past, it is in 2008. Notice that. Okay, I'll do one thing, I'll speak with the support people and get it fixed. Okay, so this is what as of. Yeah? No, like here the server date is in past, so I cannot close this in the with the past date. That is a problem. It says like it is possible in current period only, so 05 and 06. Okay, but our transactions are always in the, it is done in the past. So I have to ask them to reset the server date basically. If we'll do try to create a new one, fashion we. Okay, let me change this, delete this delivery. Fashion VL01N. Okay. Yeah, but it is in year 11. It is in year 11. That is the problem. That is the problem. No, sir, it is for 2011. 5-2011 or 6-2011. Okay. Yeah. So let me put it this way. 1950. Can you see the dates are taking? Yeah. So let us put it down. Okay. You got lost somewhere. Okay, so let me put it as 19/5/2011. Okay. So similarly, my date is this. 2905. Which we can change the dates to 2005, 2011. But I doubt it. Go to see the last step. Okay, picking that is after loading that. What else is there? 25, 5, yeah. Okay. 2011. So /1465. Okay. / So this is my date and dates are fine. Looking fine. Okay. So I can create the transfer order here itself. Okay, 25/5/2011. Okay. Transfer is created. /NV02N. What is it picking? Okay, fully picked. And posting only possible in periods 2011-06 and 2009-05 in company code 1000. Okay. No, like it has to be fixed before proceeding. Okay, I will check with the section people regarding, I mean support people regarding that. So we will see the theory part now. Okay, it is until later. I mean like okay, tomorrow class we can see the complete cycle in action. Okay, so we will see the warrior sales process. Okay. Come again? Yeah. In slide it is not there. In slide it is not there. I can but I can just but isn't it what I was trying to do now? Like I said, like okay, I'm creating the sales order. Yeah. No, I don't have that kind of. No. Okay. So we have the pre-sales activities. Our pre-sales activities are like maintaining the customer master, that is entering and tracking the customer contacts. Okay. We are taking down the inquiries, quotations, and this kind of activities are called as pre-sales activities. Why they are called as pre-sales activities? Because there is no guarantee that they will be contributing to your sales sales order. For example, somebody can receive a quotation, but until unless they give you a firm purchase order, it is not going to be a part of your sales. Okay, you can use these pre-sales activities for your business building your business strategy. For example, like after a while you can contact the person who had taken the quotation but hadn't come back. To take their feedback and ask like okay, why they hadn't come back, whether it is any price issue or delivery issue. So So based on that, you can formulate your or streamline your business. So that is why these activities are grouped under the pre-sales activities. Then you start the sales order processing. Okay. In the sales order, you have the customer and material information, price information for all financial statement items, which means for all the items you will be having the prices. That's what you saw in the sales order. Anyway, at least we can see the sales order. That's the problem. Slash NVA02. So we had seen what is the price of that. Okay. If you still want to see the further breakdowns, like what are all the components? If we say that $10 is the price, does that mean that $10 is a single entity? What are the components of that $10? Okay. Okay, your freight, surcharges, discounts, everything will be there. Net price, okay. So here our net price is $2,299. If you select this dollar icon or coin icon, which reads as item conditions, you can see the breakup. So the price is $2,299. Okay. Then the output tax came to 19%. The value is €873. Okay. And the customer is promised a discount of 3% if she paid within so and so time. Okay. So that is this. Okay. So you can see the breakup of your prices here in the conditions tab on the item. You see the customer and material information. Material information is what we saw about in that item tab. Okay. Then you see the price information. Information about delivery dates and delivery quantities. That is what we saw in the schedule lines. If you go to the schedule lines, you can see what is my delivery date and what are all the quantities that will be delivered on so and so date. Okay. Then you see information about shipping processing. Shipping processing says like from which shipping point this material is going to be delivered from. What is the shipping point and what is my plant? Okay. Here now it is grayed out because you have created a delivery. After creating a delivery, you cannot change the shipping details here. Then you have information about billing. Information about billing says like how the customer is going to be charged for this or how he is going to be paid for this. Okay. So we go to the customer billing plans or billing documents. Okay, there is no billing plans. Go to billing document. It says okay, what is the terms of payment for customer and what is the info terms agreed with this particular customer. Okay. So that's what it says. Sales order normally contains customer material information, price information for all financial items, then information about delivery, dates, quantity, information shipping processing and billing. Okay. So this is what we saw in the schedule line level of the item. If you go to the item schedule line, you can see whether if this article is going to be procured or prepared or sold from the stock. So here you can see the link between the purchasing as well as the production. As of now, this is just a normal sale from stock item, so you don't have anything here. Okay. Then we saw the shipping. We created the outbound deliveries. Okay. Then we carried out the picking by creating the transfer orders. We then do the packing. Actually, picking and packing are the optional activities. If I don't enable the picking and packing activities, then I can create delivery. I can do the post goods issue there itself. Okay. you can do the create the delivery, carry out the picking, packing, and do the post goods issue. And then, based on what you had delivered to the customer, you are going to create the good invoices. I mean, like, okay, this creating the invoices for the goods that you had delivered, that is fine. What is that you had agreed for a service item, for example, like you had sold a computer, and you had, along with that, you had sold an annual maintenance agreement. Okay. For the computer you had delivered, you can bill, but the agreement, you cannot deliver it physically. Okay. So in such cases, you can bill the agreement directly from the sales order. Okay. So billing supports creating invoices for your deliveries as well as the services. There is no business that doesn't have any discrepancy. You will always be having some returns, complaints, undercharging, overcharging, under delivery, over delivery. Okay. So in these cases, you will be settling your customer with a credit memo or debit memo. Okay. So your billing will help in creating the credit memos as well as debit memos. Okay. Sometimes you had sent the invoice, there will be some returns or some complaints which will force you to cancel the invoices. Okay. So you can cancel the invoice and restart the invoicing process again. Okay. And the moment you save the billing, the system automatically creates the accounting entries to post it to the accounting directly. I mean, like, that is what we saw now in the conditions. When you say, like, it is 2,299, it is not only the 2,299. It has the tax component, discount component. Okay. So whenever you receive the 2,299 from the customer, a part of that has to be posted to the tax account. The part of that has to be posted to the discount account or freight account. Okay. So when you create a billing document, the system automatically transfers the data from billing to accounting. So these are all the activities that we normally do in the sales order process. Okay, is it clear? Preeti? Invoice part, we create the invoice. We create the invoice and these things will be sent to the financial module, that's it. What happens is, then the financial module receives the payments from sales and distribution module, and then it posts to the appropriate GL accounts. Those activities will be done with the finance. However, while configuring these activities, the account will be created by the finance people. I mean, that is one area where SD and finance has to work in close. Yeah. Because they will be creating the account numbers and everything, and we will tell. Yeah, that's right. Okay. So we will wind up for today, and I will look into this issue and I will get it solved so that tomorrow you can create the sales orders and everything. Okay. No, you cannot do that. I will send you the document, but you cannot do that. So as of now, today just go through what are things we have seen. Okay. Is it fine, Abhi? I'll try to get it fixed today. Okay. Your class recording is what I'm saying. Yeah. Yeah, okay. The material which I sent today, that we'll be having the tomorrow's material also. Okay. Okay, do one thing, everybody mute your microphone. Only if I ask something, else if you want to tell anything, then you can unmute and speak and mute it again. It's okay, Abhin. So we will follow this from tomorrow.